What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install the Better Loot plugin in Rust. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In the chaotic lands of Rust, the fight for resources and items is a constant battle between players. Whether it's gathering wood or collecting loot from containers, a lot of people believe the default setting makes it too difficult to really optimize your items. Better Loot is the way to fix this by redefining the Rust loot tables for any container. Whether you increase the multiplier of scrap or you want more of an item to drop, this is all available with the configuration options in your panel. Let's go over how to install and use this plugin. Visit the Better Loot uMod page and in the top right, press download and save the file in a safe location for later. After this, head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then scroll down to the Enable uMod Support section and make sure that that checkbox is selected. While still on the main panel page, head to the FTP file access on the left-hand side and log in. Here, head to the Oxide folder, followed by the Plugins folder, and then press Upload in the top left and drag and drop your plugin file. Once it has 100% uploaded, you can return to the main panel page and restart the server. To configure this plugin, return to the FTP file access and log in just like before. Enter the Oxide folder and then the Config folder, and then find the Better Loot folder and press Edit to the far right. Once the text editor opens, you can start tweaking your settings. For some of the generic settings, blueprint probability is the percentage chance for a blueprint to spawn. List updates on loaded lists the loot changes whenever the plugin loads. Remove stacked containers removes any containers that are in or on each other. And watched prefabs is a list for every container that the plugin will adjust loot for. For loot settings, enable hammer loot cycle shows whether loot will refresh when it's hit by a hammer. Hammer loot cycle times shows how many seconds until the loot refreshes from the hammer. The loot multiplier is the multiplier for the loot found inside containers, and scrap multiplier is multiplier for the scrap that is found in containers. For the rarity settings, adjusting these values will allow you to override the rarity of specific items in a container. By default, this includes the auto turret, M249, and targeting computer. The higher a number, the more rare it will be to find. Along with the configuration options, there are a few more folders that are found within the Oxide, Data, Better Loot. Here you will find three files with their own uses. Blacklist, which is a list of items that are blacklisted from being adjusted by the Better Loot plugin. This file can be edited manually or by using the blacklist add item and blacklist delete item commands as the owner in-game. To start, this will only include the flare item. Loot tables allows you to manually adjust which items appear in certain containers and how many of that item can appear. And the names list will display each of the in-game item code names for any of the previous config files. With that, you now know how to install and get started with the Better Loot plugin for Rust. With so many configuration options, you can completely tweak your server to fit your exact needs. This can be beneficial for adding more ammunition, healing items, or even just increasing the amount of scrap that can be found. You can have complete control over this mod, which makes it that much more exciting to use. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.